Hello everyone, and welcome to the Modern Java course. In this video, we'll discuss a set of language features that make Java just a little bit less verbose. We'll see the flaws of the old switch statement and how the new improvements in Java can improve the reliability of your code while reducing boilerplate. Before I proceed, as usual, the code for this and the other videos in this series is available in my GitHub page. So check out this project, start it, and follow me on GitHub. Switch is a bit of a problematic statement. It is often used with enum, but in most cases, the right thing would be to add a method into the enum. However, switch in Java can work with enums that are not controlled by the developer, with numbers, with strings and objects. It is a very powerful tool that can save us from complex structures and nested if statements. Unfortunately, the standard version of the switch in Java is problematic. See this example. There are several problematic things here. Some are subtle, but some are obvious. First, the code is very verbose. Second, if we forget a break, the code will fall over to the next statement and we will get the wrong value. Third is that if a denum is added, the code will fail. We can add a default switch statement that throws an exception. But that is bad. It means the failure will happen at runtime, not at compile time. We can do better with switch expressions. This code solves all the problems mentioned. It is not verbose. We assign a result directly from the switch and don't even need a return statement or break. If we add a denum, the code will not compile. It must be exhaustive, so we don't need a default entry. This does have one problem though. It's a bit too simple. What if we want to write something more sophisticated in the switch? To solve that, we can use yield instead of break. This makes the expression into a more traditional switch statement, as you can see here. Notice that yield is a context-sensitive keyword in Java. That means it only acts as a keyword inside a switch statement like this. In this particular context, you can still use yield to name methods and variables. In fact, the thread class has a yield method, and that's perfectly fine. With JDK 19, we have a new type of pattern matching switch expression. Say we have a shape object and would like to create custom code for various subclasses. It is in a third-party library, so we can't do that via inheritance, which would normally be the preferred way. The normal way of solving this would be a series of if statements and instance of tests. The pattern matching switch simplifies this code. Notice the code removes the need for a cast. We already have a variable of the right type. Also notice that the default statement is required. Otherwise, the switch statement would not be exhaustive. The compiler will not allow it. There is a solution for that in sealed classes. Sealed classes make sense for an API provider that wants to guard the hierarchy against modification. Java provides the final keyword for that. String is final, which means that we can't extend it. That is not bad. But what if Oracle wants to extend string? They can't either. Well, they can, but they will have to make string non-final. And that would mean anyone can extend it. That is a problem and a potential security risk. What we sometimes want is a class that is final to a limited group of subclasses that we know about. That is a sealed class. Notice that sealed A and sealed B must be final or sealed, otherwise the code will not compile. This lets us control the inheritance hierarchy and keep it under control while maintaining some flexibility that final doesn't allow. Once we have that hierarchy, we can write a switch without a default clause, since the compiler knows there are no additional options. If we will add another class to the sealed hierarchy, the compilation will fail. This lets us write code that is more reliable and makes use of the capabilities in the compiler. I don't use switch statements as much in my day-to-day coding, but for those few times where I need them, these changes are a blessing. In the next video, we will discuss several miscellaneous features such as the var keyword, pattern matching, instance of, and text blocks. Follow through the videos to check out the full course. If you have any questions, please use the comment section. Thank you.